Do you struggle to decide what criteria to use when searching for an Amazon FBA product ideas? With a lot of factors to consider and examine before finding the right profitable product, it can get really unclear what metrics to set in order to hit the best product to sell on Amazon. In this video, you will learn how to do an Amazon product research using Helium 10 Black Box and Xray to find that sweet spot between profitability and a unique opportunity to differentiate from the rest of the competition. If you want to try Helium 10 by yourself or yourself, check the link below in the description. There are also ongoing discounts for Helium 10, 10% lifetime or 50% first month. So check the codes, coupon codes to use in the description. This video is brought to you by one of our Orange Klik team members, Nikki. She helps Amazon sellers to research products. And of course, if you like the videos we create, don't forget to click like and subscribe buttons below.
Hi everyone, Nikki here from Orange Klik team. Today, I'm going to show you how I help my clients find winning products using the black box and Xray tool from Helium 10. In this video, you'll learn how to set criteria to find your potential winning product. Use black box and Xray tool from Helium 10 to find niche products and to validate the demand trend of your product using Google Trends. But before we deep dive into these two tools, we must first answer these questions that every Amazon FBA seller asks themselves: where do I begin? And if I do find a product, how do I know if it's profitable? So the answer to this question is to define your target market. Once you understand your target market, you can identify the product features that they want and shape your offering to those needs. Try to think of a problem that your ideal customer faces. How does your product answer those problems? So when you're able to define your target market, you can now start looking for those items in the bestsellers lists on Amazon, Etsy, and in other major supplier sites like Alibaba or AliExpress. Now, when I use Helium 10 as my product research method, there's a lot of tools inside this software that can easily save me time from figuring out how my competitors are doing. With Black Box, for example, I can just set my product criteria and voila, it produces a list in seconds. And to give you a better idea of how it looks like, I'm going to walk you through on how I use Black Box to find those niche products in seconds. This works especially when you haven't decided yet what target market are you going to cater, but you already have preference as to what category you would most likely to sell. If you do have a target market in mind, you can simply type that specific target market's keywords in search tab, and this time we will be using the Xray tool by Helium 10 to get a comprehensive estimate on current key performance indicators of the competitors. All right, so here are my product research criteria in order to find the winning product on Amazon. So we have single item product only, no variation and no bundles. Keyword search volume should be 1,000 and up, and the price should be $25 and up. Sales units should be 300 and up, and the revenue should be 9,000 USD and up, and a revenue of 500 and below. The profit margin, we are shooting for 25% and up. And the item weight should be 3 pounds and below. We are shooting for small standard size. And so important things to consider. Your product should not be patented or that does not have any trademark. And it's not included in hazmat and gated category. And it's eligible for PPC. This is very important, as if you can create a campaign around that product, there would be a greater chance to push for increase in sales and brand awareness. Also, choose a product that is not breakable and not electronic. Another way to know that your product is in demand and is searched by your target audience all throughout the year is the Google Trends. If it has a steady trend in Google Trends and all throughout the year, then you have an indicator that your product is being searched and in demand almost every month of the year. Also, you can see the seasonality of the product. If you're looking to launch a product, just sell it on the specific season, then Google Trends is one of the ways to find out if this product is being searched for in this particular season. And last but not the least, an opportunity for improvement. Looking at the review ratings of your competitors, you will be able to see what are those issues that the current customers are facing while using this product, and you will be able to improve on that, create a new feature that directly addresses that issue and provides the solution. And ultimately, that would be your unique selling point to stand out and be regarded as a better product amongst the other sellers. Now, I'm going to walk you through on how I use Black Box and Helium 10 in finding niche products. So right now, we are in the Helium 10 dashboard, and I'm going to select Black Box as one of the 25 tools in this amazing suite of a software for Amazon sellers. And based from the criteria that I have shared a while ago, I will be now exploring some products from kitchen and dining. All right, I will put here a minimum revenue of $9,000 per month and a minimum price of $25. Revenue count should be not over 500, and the size tier would be small standard size. For the advanced filters, we would be setting up the monthly sales unit of 300 pieces per month, and the maximum of weight should be not more than 3 pounds, and the fulfillment should be by FBA, because we would like to know which sellers are selling products using Fulfilled by Amazon. Using the criteria that we have, these are going to be our benchmarks for the filters that we're going to use here in Blockbox. All right, so in a matter of seconds, I was able to see 18 results from Black Box. Here they're showing those products that have passed our criteria based from the price, monthly sales, monthly revenues, BSR, review count, and ratings. As far as I can see, we are looking into Easter table runners, tumblers. So for now, I can see that this product is a good one because this is good for people who are fond of organizing their pantry or their drawers. Being able to launch a product that organizes their spice would be a good one. And judging from this seller's monthly revenue at 10,523, it is doing really well because it has a monthly revenue of 319 units. The price is very good at 32.99. Means that it is more than enough to cover the Amazon FBA fulfillment costs and great room for higher profit margin. So looking at the review ratings of 4.2 out of 5 and a 37 review count in total, it means that this product has a lot of things to improve. It shows that there's an opportunity for improvement. Now you will be able to look into the negative reviews and in the positive reviews and look into the specific features that you can add and develop in order to design a spice rack organizer that directly answers or gives solutions to that issue that those customers are currently facing with this product. And so this product has been only launched 5 months ago. And I must say that over its sales trend of 90 days, it's really doing well because it has like 511% increase. So I would pin this as one of my products. Another one that I'm looking here is this one. Okay, this one, the chopping board. Because another market to look into is housewarming gifts or people who love charcuterie and cheese. This is a good way to start as in the sales trend. It has also increased in 90 days. Judging from the best sales period, it is selling really high during the month of March. It also passed all of my criteria, which is the minimum of $25 and a monthly sales of $434 with a revenue of $11,279 and the reviews are only 101. So definitely there is room for us to squeeze in this market and be able to win the market share. Granted that we do the necessary improvements from this product, may it be a better design, better material, better shape. Overall, looking into improving the product better than this particular competitor. I would pin this and regard this as one of my potential winning product. And another one that I can see from this list is this apron. So this apron is catering to those people who are working in bistros, in cafes, or in a type of gastropub. This type of apron is very premium. Let us see. All right, so this apron is very premium. It has utility pockets. What you can do with this is to maybe add a better design, better utility pockets, a more premium material to use. And this product has only been launched 2 months ago and is already performing well within the 90 days period of 49 5% and is already selling 553 units per month with a price of $34.99. Again, this price is really good in terms of covering Amazon FBA fulfillment fees. And if you're able to find a manufacturer that gives you lesser costs in terms of labor and materials, then you would most likely to have a very good profit margin with this list price. And with a monthly revenue of $18,796, this is really a good indication that this type of product is selling really well. And the fact that it has 4.3 ratings out of 5 means that there is a room for improvement. And the job here is to look into, again, the negative reviews and the positive reviews. Focus on combining those strong features that the customers love and those features that the customers would like to have or would like this product to have improved on and become this one unique selling that your product is going to offer. So, yep, again, this is how I use Black Box in order to find those products, niche products that we wouldn't usually know. And in a matter of seconds, it was able to give me a result of 18 options. And so out of those 18, I was able to choose 3 very promising products: a spice rack organizer, a cutting board good for housewarming gifts, and utility apron for bistro server aprons. Okay, so all right, moving on to Xray tool. So for Xray tool, this is very good in terms of when you already have a specific target market in mind and you already understand how they think and what are the possible problems that they would like to be solved. And so in my case, I would like to go and find a product that I think coffee lovers will like to have. And in this case, coffee kettles. What I love about Amazon is that they suggest long tail keywords that we can explore and discover more things about this general keyword search term, which is coffee kettles. Now I can see that there are more specific coffee kettles for different specific functionality. Okay, so we have coffee kettle for stovetop, coffee kettle for camping, coffee kettle for car, coffee kettle for cafe, coffee kettle for induction cooker, and coffee kettle for thermometers. So the list goes on and it's up to you to choose which one of these long tail keywords would you like to deep dive into. Like for me, I would like to choose this coffee kettle gooseneck. All right, so based from the results, I can see that this product is quite small, and especially this one. So it's small and lightweight because it's made up of stainless steel. Okay, so aesthetically, it looks really nice and really classic. And so what I would do is I would go to Helium 10 Chrome extension and choose Xray tool. And with Xray tool, gives you a comprehensive estimate on the current key performance indicators of the competitors. These are the total revenue, average BSR, average price, average reviews, and success score. The Xray features relative to the success score of various products give sellers enough data to make an informed decision about the product they choose to sell and have a baseline model for their Amazon business. So here, as you can see, I am going to filter this further by hiding the sponsored products result because I would most likely see my competitors who are having organic sales only. And the next thing is I would be filtering my revenue from highest to lowest. And the next, I would be removing those products that have glass, like this one, glass as the material, main material, and those products that has electronics because we are staying away from breakables and electronic products. So what I would be leaving out in this list are those products that has the same material as this one, stainless steel, and the same appearance, the same look. After careful removal of those products that are not necessarily the same material and the same appearance or look of the product that I would like to launch on Amazon, I was able to take out items that has glass in them and some products that has electronics. And so I was able to filter out all of those things. And what I have now is a list of those competitors that are offering the same product. And the results that I'm going to see right now are relative to what I want to see in terms of the success score of these competitors. So judging from the revenue score, the average revenue of each competitor in this product is at 11,900. So it's above our minimum revenue, which is 9,000. And for the average price, it is also above our minimum criteria, which is 25. And it shows that $30 will be more than enough to cover the Amazon FBA fulfillment fees. And we will still have enough room for a very good profit margin. And then for the average reviews, yes, it went above than our minimum average of 500 and below. But then again, 1,549 is not a lot. So there is still room for us to squeeze in and get that that share of the market pie. And so judging from this, I also filtered my revenue from highest to lowest. And as you can see, out of top 20 of this list, I have 7 competitors who are earning more than 9,000 per month. That's not bad. And from looking at the review count, most of them are having 286, more less than 500. Therefore, there is still room for us to get into the mix and, you know, get into the mix and get that share of the market pie. And so looking at the ratings as well, revenue ratings, we have 4.6, 4.7, 4.1, 4.4. And so this is another indication of an opportunity to improve on this product. So if we can only go through the negative reviews that was given and going through all the positive reviews that people love about this product, we can combine all of those things, add a new feature to that product, and ultimately sell that as our unique selling point to stand out and differentiate above the rest. Also, keep in mind that the average weight of this product is around 1.4, 1.5. It's relatively small and light. This will also be beneficial to you to save some costs when it comes to packaging. It will also save you costs in terms of storage fees, in terms of storing it in Amazon fulfillment warehouses. So, yep, I guess I would still recommend selling this product, even though the average reviews did not quite pass my minimum requirement, but then again, it passed more than half of my criteria. And so this is worth deep diving into and can possibly a winning product in the future. So again, if you do have a target market in mind, you can just use those keywords that you have and try to search it in the Amazon search results. Use the Amazon Chrome extension and use the Xray tool, and you will be able to find the list of products that will ultimately give you a benchmark of those competitive scores and the average price that you would like to position yourself into this mix. And so, yep, I hope I helped you get an idea on how to set your criteria as well and be able to search more quality products, more quality products that could have a potential profitability in the near future. Again, this is Nikki from Orange Klik Team. Don't forget to subscribe and watch our YouTube videos. Klik like and subscribe.
I hope this video gave you an idea or ideas how you can find your next profitable Amazon FBA product. If you want to try Helium 10 tools for yourself, check the links below in the description of this video. Also, there's some coupon codes. And now I recommend you to watch other video where Sumner Hobart, our guest, is sharing 4 strategies for Amazon product research.